Welcome to London, guys.
Thank you.
I can't believe it's been 4 years since we did almost exactly this.
Mm-hmm. Right.
In those 4 years...
Did we have to hold these cumbersome microphones 4 years ago?
You did have to do that 4 years ago. I'm surprised you don't remember, actually.
I don't.
Yeah. 4 years ago, first movie came out. Did it change your lives and your careers as much as maybe you thought it was going to at the time?
Yeah, it changed my life in a lot of ways. I didn't know what to expect because I'd never made a movie before. So for me, the whole thing was such an overwhelming experience. I just tried to get through it on a daily basis, first when we were shooting the movie and then when we were promoting it. But it's given me so many opportunities and allowed me to start a production company, which has been really beneficial to me both creatively and professionally in the past few years. And also it's forged friendships with people that I know I'll be working with and spending time with for the duration of my career and my life. So that's also really gratifying.
You guys have been in Australia, Germany already. Do you have any idea what's going on day to day at the moment? Pretty punishing press tour. How are you holding up?
It's been a lot of fun. It's a great chance to see the world. You know, we have been to Sydney, to Dubai for a second and a half, and then Moscow and Berlin. And last time we went even more places. We're going to go to Mexico next, and then New York and Los Angeles. So we have a good time. We enjoy one another, and we're all foodies, so we love to eat at, you know, the great spots wherever we go. We get a chance to take in the sights when we can. We did it in Berlin when we had a couple of days off. So not many people get this great opportunity to go around with a movie that they enjoy, people they enjoy, and I think we're, you know, we all kind of take advantage of it as much as we can.
Plus, you brought the sunshine to London as well. Don't know how you managed that.
Man.
Thank you.
My friend and I spent 3 hours in Hyde Park yesterday reading on a blanket and taking in the sun and walking around. It was absolutely gorgeous, yeah.
Fantastic. The movie's great. I saw it last night. Seems a lot more physical, actually, for both of you. It's a lot of running. I know that's been referenced in a couple interviews before. Yeah. Any bumps and bruises? Any scrapes you guys got?
I had a little bit of a muscle pull in my leg while I was sprint training early on. But, you know, we're really well taken care of in a film this big with physical therapy and massage and stunt team that really prepares us for the action that we have to engage. And for me personally, I'd never done anything to this level of physical exertion for a movie. So it was great to push myself right up to my limits and then bust through them. And I hope that it pays off in the movie. I thought that the whole sequence at the end for me was really exhilarating. So but other than that, I think we all escaped injury pretty well. Knock on wood, that continues to be the case.
Did you need any physio or massage for your eyebrows to grow back?
No. Luckily those take care of themselves. I don't need to encourage their growth. Hopefully that'll continue as well.
Eyebrow propecia.
I imagine you've spent the last few weeks maybe, I don't know, dodging Star Wars questions. You're getting the same one all the time. But I'll ask the same one. Have you asked JJ for a part?
I will play an Ewok or
extra tall one.
Over. No. You know, they have all kinds of things.
Yeah.
We'll do our motion capture situation. Yeah. No, I don't know. I'm thrilled for JJ, and I can't wait to see what he does with that world. And, I can't think of a better and more appropriate person to take over that franchise than him. So the boldness of it is only exceeded by the ambition of it, and that makes me thrilled for him.
Sure. I mean, obviously a perfect choice. I mean, would it be disappointing, though, if he wasn't able to come back and do the third Star Trek, which I guess is inevitable considering how well this one's clearly going to do? Yeah, there you go.
Hello, purple microphone. I would be disappointed, and it doesn't look like there's much of a chance that he could come back to direct it unless we decide to do the third film, if there is one, many years down the road. So it's unfortunate, but you know, he's a man with his own set of desires and ambitions. I can only imagine what it must have been like when someone said, here are the keys to the kingdom of Star Wars, go make it your own. I mean, I think any fanboy, no matter how old, would jump at the opportunity. But, you know, I know that he's very protective of what he's done with Star Trek and that he would, like any kind of, you know, fatherly figure, kind of usher in whoever else would come in to take care of it and welcome them in as a part of the family, but make well sure that the franchise was taken care of.
Chris and Zachary, thank you very much.
Thank you.
See you tonight in the red carpet.
All right.
Thank you.
See you soon.
Thanks, man.